On behalf of all of us here, particularly at the Quantum Exchange, I just wanted to welcome all of you to the 5th Annual Summit, and actually our first fully in-person summit since 2019. And it's great to see so many students in the room as well. And I just want to take a few minutes to put some of these things in perspective for you as we start the summit. You know, being at the leading edge of a paradigm shift in information technology is an amazing opportunity for all of us. We have a chance not just to define the fields of quantum science and engineering, but to also establish the foundational values. Think about developing an environment that's based on collaboration and inclusion. One of the nice things about our group right now is that we're bringing together people from academia, from industry, from government, all together to see how we can drive this field forward. And it does require substantial national and regional investments, and they're happening. So I just want to put these a little bit in perspective. Nationally, the CHIPS and Science Act that was signed by President Biden this summer provides incredible new investments for us in quantum research, in workforce development, and the R&D infrastructure overall to drive science and economic development. Now, the federal government also released, and some of you may not have looked at this, the National Strategic Plan for Quantum Information Science and Technology Workforce Development. One of the nice things about that is it brings this to a public perspective, the importance of building a national workforce for this new field. And just in the last few months, new joint statements on collaboration were signed between the United States and Switzerland, Denmark, Sweden, Finland, and Australia to really encourage open and free collaboration between the different countries. Now, in our region, the Chicago Quantum Exchange itself, as Paul mentioned, is a pretty unique environment between UIUC, Northwestern University, Argonne National Laboratory, Fermi National Laboratory, and more than 40 industry and nonprofit partners. You know, this region has attracted an incredible number of new companies over the last year through Duality, the quantum startup accelerator that's been built here. And we worked closely just this year with some of our international partners in the UK and in France to jointly define how this field might move forward between our different countries. Now, one other thing that's pretty exciting this year is in partnership with the Moore Foundation, we've launched the Open Quantum Initiative, an undergraduate research fellowship to attract diverse students from across the disciplines and across the country to work in our CQE universities and laboratories. Our hope is to use this to foster the next generation of scientists from very broad communities that normally might not be exposed to this field. And we're working ahead to come up with new models, and we'd like all of you, of course, to help this. How do we drive collaboration? In June, we established Working Together, one of the longest regional quantum networks in the country, 124 miles of fiber-connected institutions that's already driving quantum security protocols with our industrial partners. It's a pretty exciting enterprise because it moves some of the science from the laboratory into the real world, which, in the case of Chicago, means weather. Yeah, so for those of us who moved here from California, it's a bitter reminder. So what about today? So for today and tomorrow, we're going to hear from experts across academia and from industry and from the government, people who are leading this field, thinking about research and also about commercialization. So let's use these presentations to really catalyze discussions. Please ask lots of questions. Please push our speakers, push them into being slightly uncomfortable. And since you're the first speaker, just be prepared. So in addition to hearing from our keynote speakers and our panels today, we're really excited that this year's summit is going to launch the work of the 2022 Quantum Creators Prize awardees. These are students, talented, early career researchers who are helping to define this new field and new directions, the future, if you like, of our discipline. Now, finally, we hope that all of you can join us for a public event this evening at the Chicago Cultural Center on building a quantum secure workforce, well, quantum secure future in Chicago. And this event will feature Marco Pistoia from JP Morgan Chase, Marella Kolova from QuantOptican, Gene Whalen of the Washington Post. Now, you may see these people that are sort of the side of me lingering around the summit and approaching you. Don't be concerned. These are our quantum influencers. These are people who are going to play an important role in the QSTEAM effort, which stands for Quantum Information Science, Technology, Engineering, Arts, and Mathematics. So this is funded by the National Science Foundation and led by Professor Zeke Johnson Halpern at Ohio State University. QSTEAM is an initiative to create a transformational national educational model for quantum information science and engineering. Now, these influencers are going to use their creative genius to spread the word to normally untapped talent pools such as students at HBCUs and different institutions that might otherwise not be reached. So as I approach you with a handheld camera, please feel free to give your comments. Are you two in the audience here? If you are, could you stand up just for a minute?